What's going on, guys? So today I'm going to go over the entire layout of Dustin Poirier's camp because we are getting close to UFC 264, the trilogy fight with Conor McGregor. I know you guys have been asking me about it, so now I'm going to go over the entire layout for you right now. All right, so I'm gonna go over the focus points for the entire 8 weeks of camp. Now, obviously we've been putting in work outside of camp. Year round, he's getting stronger through just basic tempo movements or getting just more of a base of strength and built in aerobic capacity. Now, he has a great gas tank year round. He can actually go from being home in Louisiana, training at his home gym, and then coming to the main gym here in Florida and working on, you know, basically going right into it, not having to pick up anything. And that's really good because when you have a guy that is ready and capable and already fit, now you can throw him in the mix and we can work on more of that specificity of the sport. We can work on what he needs to do inside of the fight or getting closer to the fight that will correlate over to where he can be successful there. So for the focus points, we want to look at three major factors, all right? The first one is going to be established movement efficiency. And what I mean by that is because of the hip issue that he's had in the past, right? We weren't able to really get into positions and have him be strong in those positions and create force. Now that he has a full functioning hip the way it should be, now we can work on those particular movements or those efficient exercises that are going to correlate over to the sport. And now we can get him stronger in all different ranges. So mobility is going to be a key factor. Now, what is mobility? Well, mobility is going to be the active end range control of a joint. Now, we want to work on the muscles that cross that joint, but we also want to make sure that he can move and get into positions and also be structured and sound and have that force production be produced in those positions. So we worked on mobility from an overall perspective and then also working to enhance his movement efficiency through mobility. Also, stability. You're looking at joints, right? The knee joint needs to be stable. The lumbar needs to be stable. So with that, we want to make sure that we're increasing the strength and stability of the surrounding tissue that holds that joint together. So that can allow him to be stiffened when he needs to throw a punch so that there's no laxity. And that's going to allow him to be more powerful at the end range of his strikes. Another thing from a stability standpoint is we want to enhance his trunk stability so that when he gets in grappling exchanges or he's in close quarters, he's not getting tossed around inside the clinch, right? So we want him to be dominant inside the clinch, making sure that he doesn't get turned around or anything else of that nature, and he is in control of every position, all right? Next is gonna be strength, and like I said before, we've developed that base of strength, working through relative strength and getting closer up into the fight. You have special strengths that we always work on, whether it be speed strength, strength speed, explosive strength, and strength endurance. Those are gonna be omnipresent throughout the year. But when you're talking about getting closer to a fight, we need to make sure that it's around the speed of the sport. So primarily when you get 8 weeks out, we're looking at more of that speed strength, right? We wanna be able to produce force with higher velocities. So speed strength and explosive strength are definitely gonna be worked into the program along with that strength endurance because he needs to be strong throughout the entire 25 minutes of the fight. So we worked on things in that manner, whether it be, you know, working with accommodated resistance with band tension, making sure that the percentages of weight being 50 to 60% are conducive to speed strength. And then doing things like med ball throws and plyometrics are also gonna be important too. Now I'll get into that in a second. Number two is gonna be speed, agility, quickness, and overall power, right? We talked about the special strengths. This goes hand in hand with that. Again, I wanted to make sure that he was able to get in and out of the pocket and move more efficiently to elude any type of damage that may occur or something that, you know, may arise from the offensive side of his opponent. Now, getting into what we've developed here. So we've developed the speed, the agility, the quickness through certain cone drills, certain ladder techniques, and bag work drills. And you, as you can see right here in the video, that we've been working to enhance his change of direction, to his movement throughout, you know, all different ranges, and so that he can keep his eyes on the target by still moving his feet in all those different directions, increasing all of the movements that we need to allow him to be obviously in control of the fight wherever it goes. All right. Med ball throws, ballistics, hurdle hops, box jumps, All these things here, like you see in the video, are important for increasing explosive power through the hips and triple extension on top of reversal or rotational strength and power. So when you reverse a movement, let's say for instance, he's in a grappling situation, we wanna make sure that he has power throughout his transverse plane so that he doesn't get either swept or that he can sweep and move and get into a better position on the ground. But also when you're talking about striking, obviously you wanna be able to create force through that rotational plane so that again, he can get that knockout one more time. Now, lastly, cognitive conditioning. That was where we brought in Mr. Mental Muscle himself, right? Nick shows us how we can implement certain movements and certain drills to enhance not only hand-eye coordination, reaction timing, but we can also work on depth perception. We can work on memory. We can work on, you know, pattern recognition. And so that when he's in the fight and he sees these things happen, he's able to react a lot faster and be able to create that offense off of the defense. And that's really what Dustin wants to do, or at least in any fight, that's where the main focus is gonna be, right? We wanna make sure that we're not getting hit and that we can get, and then we can hit. So the goal really, again, is always be defensive and then work your offense after that. So again, using the cognitive conditioning protocols, we were able to enhance, not from a physical standpoint, but from a cognition standpoint and a memory and mind standpoint, which was gonna definitely help him going into the fight. Okay, so you guys wanna check out more about that, you can check out Mr. Mental Muscle on Instagram. All right, so to finalize the entire breakdown, we're basically gonna do 8 to 4 weeks out. We did speed, strength, mobility, stability, and explosive repeats. Now for the speed strength, we used accommodated resistance. We kept it in the zones that are gonna be conducive to that overall velocity to allow him to be strong, but also be powerful. And we also worked into those mobility and stability movements, whether it be FRC and also doing some stability in the trunk and the core, so that again, we can increase that power production going further with his punches and strikes, okay? Explosive repeats for the conditioning, right? That's gonna be something like a prowler push followed by a short rest. So you're looking at power endurance, or what we call explosive repeats. So again, you're taking something that's very explosive, you're recovering fast, and then going again. I'm gonna do that repeatedly for an extended amount of time, and that's gonna be drawn out throughout the entire 4 weeks that you're working that. You'll do a 3 week up and a 1 week deload. Now on the 5th week or 5 weeks out, we do a deload, a structured deload, where I bring down the volume to allow his body to recover and to get ready for the next block of training, right? Especially when it gets closer to the fight, you know what happens. There's gonna be skill strain that's gonna be picked up, the sparring becomes more intense. And so I needed to degress a little bit and make sure that he was able to recover for those hard sparring sessions in the next weeks to come. All right, now 3 to 1 week out, again, pure power, right? So we're working on potentiation clusters or post-activation potentiation, working on motor unit recruitment, working on being as explosive as possible. And we're doing that in a repeatable fashion, okay? So explosive strength there, speed, agility, quickness, footwork drills, you know, hand-eye coordination drills, agility drills with Mr. Mental Muscle, Nick Davenport, and then also the cone and bag drills that you see me do in the video. All right, then muscle endurance, right? So that's gonna be something like lactate threshold training or a circuit style of work where he's gonna do acyclical movement patterns in a long fashion or the time of the fight, right? So again, you're working up and then you're deloading at the final week. Primarily what we wanna do is the last week, we wanna do the exact amount of time that he's actually going to be in the fight for. So that's 25 minutes. You do acyclical movements, so you're jumping from upper to lower, and he's also doing things that are specific or simulated on, you know, in the fight, but again, we're not doing things from just that perspective. So he actually is gonna do some prowler pushes and he is gonna do some carries, but then he's also gonna hit pads, hit the bags, and then we also work on that inside of the skills training too as well. So he'll be grappling and transitioning into bag work drills and things like that. So there you have it. Again, the entire 8 week layout. If you wanna find out more, well, you can check out my mentorship program. Link is in the description. It's actually 50% off for a very limited time. So make sure you check it out if you're a coach looking to learn some of the methods and protocols, or if you want to just train one of the programs that I have, that's also down below. We have at least 15 programs that you can choose from. And one of my newest programs is coming out very soon, Hybrid Prime. So take a look, be on the lookout this July really good one, probably the best one that I'll have out, but fight ready, heavy hitter, ground control, and then body armor too as well. All the programs are set there for you guys if you wanna check them out. Also, if you haven't done so, make sure you subscribe to the channel, make sure you hit the notification so you know when they come out, and I'll see you again next time. Peace.